to meet on the occasion of Robert Burns, our Rabbi, on his 64th birthday.
Oh.
Quite old.
Yes.
You did some maths.
As I can see, gathered here are honorables from various lands of the globe. As John, a Welsh descendant maybe,
yes,
Davies
yes.
with an E,
yes,
cousin from the Yorkshire Dales,
yes.
Gareth and Emily of Setchford, and maybe of dark and mystic heritage. Last but not least, the two of us, Susie and Jürgen, from southern Germany of continental Europe, from the banks of River Brent.
Yes.
On the occasion of this assembly, I want to thank the most honourable John the Feather.
Alpine show.
Alpine show.
And his charming wife, Kathleen, for hosting the members of our important society, who again have made remarkable efforts to make this assembly an unforgettable success.
Thank you.
Let's raise our glasses in a toast to the hosts,
to the host.
All members of the Honourable Society.
Yes.
Hey.
Cheers.
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 Prost.
Prost.
Mac Prost.
Yes. Some hem eat, and can I eat, and some what eat that want it. But we have meat and we can eat. So let the Lord be thanked.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good. Yes,
it's not addressed to a haggis, it's to the haggis. Because to that one.
This particular one.
Yeah.
Not that one.
Not
this
one. It's a real one.
A little pedantic.
That's true.
Are we ready?
We are.
At last. Fair fall, your honest sonsy face, great chieftain of the pudding race. A boon them all, you tack your place. Painch, tripe or therm, wheel your wordy o'er grace as lang's my arm. The groaning trencher there you fill. Your herd is like a distant hill. Your pin would help to mend a mill in times of need, while through your pores the dews distill like amber bead. His knife, see, rustic labour dight, and cut you up with ready slight. Drenching your gushing entrails bright like any ditch. And then, oh, what a glorious sight. Warm reeking, rich. Then horn for horn they stretch and strive. Deal take the hindmost, on they drive. Till all their well-swelled kites alive are bent like drums.
Method.
Then old good man may like to arrive. Be thank it. Is there that or is French ragu or olio that would stow a sow or fricassee would make a spew with perfect scholar looks down with sneering scornful view on such a dinner? Poor devil. Seymour is trash, as feckless as a withered rash. His spindle shanky, a whiplash, his knee a knit. Oh, through bloody flood and field to dash, oh, how unfit. But mark, the rustic had his fed. The trembling earth resounds his tread. Back in his wailing knee a blade, he'll mack it whistle, and legs and arms and heads will shred like taps of thistle.
Look out, he's got a knife.
Ye powers, why make mankind your care, and dish him out their bill of fare. Old Scotland wants their skinky ware that jokes in luggies, but if you wish a grateful prayer,
End of the evening song, and there are two tribes, and they've each got a different version, and they will kill their version. This is the other
it's
version.
It's called The Parting Glass.
Oh, no.
Remember, mm-hmm. but you won't.
Well, last you read it to last year's to Yeah and Susie over the video. Carry on.
We are
trapped.
I'll be quiet.
Do be quiet.
I'm glad you've seen this.
When she starts drinking
whiskey and the sauce.
Indeed, exactly.
No, in the dessert.
The name of Miss Jean Ogilvy of that ilk. Oh no, all right. She stumbled on a first draft of To a Louse whilst undertaking research. Her department of obscure cultural traits at Strathclyde and Stranraer University, Octonocky House, has triumphed again. You will be delighted with that news. Tasked to investigate every public library vault, museum basement, town hall archive and government filing cabinet, they have hit the jackpot. Credit is due also to junior clerk Fiona McThrifty of Argyll and Mute, who on opening a filthy suitcase discovered in the attic of the Invercronkey public swimming baths, revealed a scrawl on the back of a beer-stained menu from the Brigadoon Hotel and Stables, Ayrshire. Now, Robert Burns spent many an evening in that establishment. Yes, it is another first draft of one of his poems. This one is the poem, Where Are the Joys I Have Met? So here it goes. Where are the joys I have met? Or A Foolish Damsel's Lament. It is dedicated to L. Truss. Now, there is no historical record of Miss L. Truss. At one time, she was thought to be a fishwife from Ayrshire or a barmaid from Alloway. She has simply disappeared into the mists of time. The poem. Where are the joys I have met in the morning that danced to my heart's desires? Where is the glee but I felt at that dawning the hopes that ambition inspires. A fighter, I ignored economic advice by cutting the top rate of tax. Let the rich drive success, bring wealth at a price, and the poor can work to the max. No quitter am I. So I kissed the Queen's hand and sacked the top Treasury man. Ignored OBR, that's the Office of Budget Responsibility.
Explanation to our German guests.
I ignored OBR, my head in the sand. I'll ruin this country if I can.
Members.
Members.
Quasi Quarteng stood by me as the markets reacted and the pound was sent round the bend. My support I retracted. Quasi was sacked. And I knew I was nearing the end. Time cannot aid me, my grief's everlasting. No hope dare a comfort bestow. I was forced into leaving, and now I am grieving, and deserted by all, I found woe.
Eltrus.
Was she so old?
So, Jürgen, you're singing G and D.
Yep.
I'm singing M and C. So, do you do G and D? Okay. Is that clear?
Join in all the way.
And Susie does E-M-C-G. There are three. Is it difficult?
Can you manage that?
Yeah, is it difficult to you?
Okay,
got it.
Mm. And actually, Robbie Burns actually wrote this.
Yes, he did.
Yes. The ink is not dry. Still not dry yet.
Actually, he said he wrote, but I think his mum did it.
Yeah, it should be dry by now. When did he die? 17. Okay.
Are you on cake mode for what?
Yeah. Just
check in.
Should all acquaintance be forgot and ever brought to mind? Should all acquaintance be forgot and all lang syne? For all in time I, my dear, for auld lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for auld lang syne. And surely you'll buy your pint cup, and surely I'll buy mine, and we'll take a cup of kindness yet for auld lang syne. For auld lang syne, I, my dear, for auld lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for auld lang syne. We stood on about the slopes and pick the daisies fine, with on that many a weary foot in old lang syne. For all the lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for old lang syne. We two have paddled in the stream from morning sun till night, but seas between us broad and broad since old lang syne. my trusty friend, and give me a hand of thine. I will take a right good welcome for old lang syne. For old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne. We'll take a cup of kindness here for old lang syne. For old lang syne, my dear, for a cup of kindness here for old lang syne.
Well done, everybody. Yay.
A loving father I'll be to thee, if thou be spared. Through all thy childish years I'll ee thee, and think weel word. Though I should be the world bested, thou's be as braw as beanly clad, and thy young years as nicely bred wi' education as any brat o' wedlock's bed in all this station. God grant that thou may aye inherit thy mither's person, grace and merit, and thy poor worthless daddy's spirit. Without his failings, 'twill please me mair to see and hear it than stock it millions.
Sorry, Rob. Sorry, Rob. Apologies. For lords and queens I dinna mourn, e'en let them die, for that they're born. But oh, prodigious to reflect, a 12-month sirs has gone to wreck. Oh, 22, in thy small space, what dire events have taken place. Of what contentment thou hast reft us, in what a pickle thou hast left us. Johnson's rule has at last been ended, lying to the monarch his doom portended, calamitous consequences dire for a man dwelling in a moral mire.
Hooray.
Lazy, careless, never read his brief, Nazanin Ratcliffe's left to their grief. Squatting in a newly papered flat, who on earth, I wonder, paid for that?
Us.
4,000 quid a roll.
I know. A snip. Covid contracts given to his friends. Where, oh, where does corruption end? Resigned or sacked, the ethics advisers, how was honesty now to guide us? Blundered on through the Chinese plague, censured even by Tory boy Haig. So I had to get that one in. Plague is difficult to rhyme with, you know, there you go. Haig is another MP. R. Curie, Patterson, Partygate, Pincher, when moral turpitude seemed the clincher. On he stumbled to more disasters, till at last ministers became his masters. Shamed by Rashford's sharp attack, after Partygate, no way back. Out on his rear, his reign was dire. Boris Johnson, pants on fire! 360 million on a bus, none of that came heir to us. So then the Tories had some fun, a summer of love, but government, none. Round the shires traipsed Truss and Sunak, buying votes from each party hack. 8 weeks of uncontested speeches, sucking our patience like a pair of leeches. Truss's desire to aid the rich, she triumphed over a despairing Rishi. With kamikaze quarting at her side, fantasy economics went for a ride. Treasury officials gin the boot, whilst Tory heartlands counted the loot. The OBR, open-mouthed, appalled, and Roundhay School a dump, she called. But her axing of the top-rate attacks pushed poorer Tories to the max. Busting, not boosting, our finances was key to blasting her guttering chances. Out went Quarteng, her best mate, licking his wounds, left to his fate. Self-proclaimed, a fighter and no quitter, South Norfolk MP defeated, bitter. All those speeches escalating pride, Jeremy Hunt has curtailed your ride. Now Sunak is our PM, green card Rishi, our hidden gem. His wife, non-dom, rich as Croesus, there our leaders, can hope now seize us? No, we're doomed when led by this scurvy bunch. Our economy dashed in inflation's crunch. The NHS and public servants broken in poverty's clutch to strikes awoken. At last, resistance to this Tory grip. Oh, 23, thou must let rip. Oh, beardless boy, I pray take care. Preserve at least the Windsor air. And what of royals, Will and Harry? Who did that sad man marry? A divorcee from the USA, the starlet used to her own way. Edward VIII did it once upon a time, loving Wallis Simpson deemed a crime. Now Harry's done the same kind of thing, upsetting Wills, Kate and King. Protecting Meghan is his right. Blasting the Mail seems also right. Exposing Camilla he deems is right. But losing to William in a fight? He should be made of sterner stuff. Soldiers are trained. Soldiers are tough. Know how to see off the enemy. Not submit weakly to family. And what of Charles? King of all he now surveys, has he at last cleaned up his ways? His wife, respectable as she ne'er was before, now called a queen, but forever a...
shame.
Welcome, New Year, thou art but 25 days old. Make thou a better start and bold. Remember, thou must have a care. Now thou hast thy daddy's chair. Thou beardless boy, though but a bairn, of politics and royalty thou's much to learn. Thou art free agent, aware of all the lies and bombast that Christian folk despise. Remember, thou art a virtuous man. Be as muckle better as ye can. And if ye are honest, true and calm, you'll fly o'er them all quite free from harm. Lang may your lum reek.
Brilliant.
Very good.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
Remember, get sloshed responsibly.